Protecting your body from bee stings is very important for you to be able to enjoy the beekeeping experience. It's also important for safety reasons. And the part of your body that is most likely to get stung the greatest number of times would be your hands, right? That's what's interacting with the hive components. That's where the bees tend to go because they're flying after the motion of your hands. And so protecting your hands is something that you should consider doing. A lot of new beekeepers will wear gloves for years and years and years only to take those gloves off. But it's really up to your comfort level. If you don't enjoy getting stung, you're going to want to protect your hands. And I will tell you, hands are among the most sensitive places to be stung. Think about it. You have a lot of nerve endings in your fingertips. So being stung on your fingertips or up under the fingernails can be incredibly painful. And again, since this is what's interacting with the bees at the hive most, this is what's most likely to be stung. Now, there is a bit of a trade-off when you wear personal protective equipment on your hands. Yes, you gain the protection from stings from that personal protective equipment, but you lose a lot of the dexterity that you may find yourself needing in beekeeping. For example, wearing gloves to move hive boxes around. It's okay, you don't need much dexterity. Maybe removing a frame, not a problem. But if you ever need to pick up a queen or do something very delicate like that, you're going to be toggling between wanting to wear gloves and wanting not to wear gloves. But this video is really about protecting your hands, especially when you consider it very important to your safety and health and enjoyment of beekeeping. Beekeepers have been wearing gloves of some type to protect the hands for many, many years. And probably among the most common styles are these gauntlet type gloves where your hands are protected. And then this sleeve goes up over the sleeve of the bee suit or whatever you're wearing, not only to protect the forearm, but also to seal that glove to your hand. This particular pair of gloves happens to have a rubber tip that's somewhat sturdy, and bees find it very difficult to sting through that. So this is a pretty good pair of gloves. The downside to this type of glove, it can be very hot, and without adequate ventilation, your hands can get quite sweaty. Maybe the most common type of glove that people wear when keeping bees are leather gloves. And here you see a very similar style to that rubber glove that I mentioned earlier. You've got the protection around your hand from the leather, and you've got that cloth-like gauntlet that will go up over your sleeve. This is a really nice pair of gloves, but I like the gloves that actually have a strip of added ventilation here. That would be these gloves. You can see the seamstress made sure that there is ventilation so you can get adequate airflow. Make no mistake, it still gets hot in these gloves, but having this ventilation gives you a little bit of airflow. You can see that this pair of gloves has been used a lot. Bees have a lot of wax and propolis in their hives, and so your gloves can get quite dirty. But if you choose the right size glove and you're going to want something that's nearly the same size as your hand, you will get enough dexterity and feel through it to be able to do most common beekeeping practices. I will tell you that some beekeepers have noticed that leather gloves can get stung a lot, and because they're made of leather, they can often hold honeybee alarm pheromones, so it might increase the number of stings on the glove, certainly within a use, maybe not between uses, but certainly within working a colony. But for the most part, these types of gloves are excellent gloves to use when beekeeping. And while I don't wear gloves any longer, I do have a pair of gloves just like this with me every time I go into a colony in case I run into a really defensive colony and I want to protect my hands from bee stings. A lot of beekeepers will wear the full-size gloves as they get into beekeeping, and then they will try to step down to no gloves at all. And one of those step downs is just the common garden glove. You can buy these at a lot of your hardware stores or, you know, housing stores or gardening stores. You can see there's no long gauntlet to go up the sleeve and seal really well, so you can get stung a lot around the wrist in these cases. But for the most part, they work a lot like a leather glove in that it protects the most sensitive parts of your hand, your fingertips, from bee stings. In research labs, a lot of our students and postdocs and technicians like to just wear nitrile or other types of gloves like this. They love the dexterity that having a pair of gloves like this affords them. They can really feel through it, And bees have, it seems, as hard or difficult time stinging through these types of gloves as they do through leather gloves. So these are the types of gloves a lot of people really enjoy. The only downside to these is your hands sweat profusely in these types of gloves, can accumulate a lot of just water in that glove from sweat, and so you may find yourself needing to switch between pairs of gloves commonly as you work different bee colonies. I want to take a moment to speak about going without gloves. As you've heard me say throughout these personal protective equipment lectures, I feel it is incredibly important that your safety, comfort, and anxiety levels are absolutely key to your enjoyment of beekeeping. So I'm never going to try to talk you out of wearing gloves. If you're comfortable wearing gloves and that's the way that you want to keep bees, you should do that. But you'll find that a lot of beekeepers over time tend to lose their gloves first, their bee suits second, but always wear their veil. So why would you want to work bees without gloves at all? Again, you get a lot of dexterity, you get a lot of feel. And what you'll notice is you will learn what you do behaviorally that causes bees to sting you, because when you don't wear gloves, you'll get stings when you do things you shouldn't. And so what you find yourself doing, even if it's subconscious, is the longer you go without gloves, you find yourself the fewer stings you get. And it's just because you're more careful. And I have a colleague who likes to tell people the best way to learn to keep bees is without gloves, is because you'll learn what you're doing to bees to make them grumpy and you'll stop doing it. That's not my sales pitch to you. I just tell you that you may end up working without gloves someday, and don't be surprised if you do. Bee stings always hurt though. So even if you get stung through a glove or without a glove, it's going to hurt very similarly. Hands are not the only extremity that you want to protect when you're working bees. You also want to protect your feet and ankles. Let's think about the ankle and feet area. So if you're wearing a bee suit or a pair of pants, for example, you're going to have that suit or that pair of pants meet your socks, and if you're lucky, be baggy enough to go over the top of the shoe or your boot. But a lot of people don't have that luxury. Maybe they're wearing shoes and not boots, so they've got that really low ground cover. So what they end up having to do is take their bee suit or pants all the way down to their shoe, and then they can run a strap of Velcro around that pants leg or a piece of tape around that pants leg to seal the leg opening and keep it where bees cannot come up into the pants leg or into the leg of the bee suit. This is a good idea. I tend to advocate that people either wear boots, high-topped shoes, or long socks when they're keeping bees. If you wear long socks, they can be your Velcro and tape for you. You can run your pants leg or your bee suit all the way to your ankle and pull your socks over the top of that, creating that same seal that you would get from Velcro or duct tape. Just a couple of things that I want to point out. You don't want to wear black or dark socks. You don't want to wear black or dark shoes. Now that's difficult because most boots are black or dark colors. Why don't you want to wear these dark colors? Well, I've worked very defensive colonies all around the world, and if I've ever had to wear a bee suit to keep those defensive bees off of me, if I am wearing dark socks or shoes, they don't go after my hands, they don't go after my veil, they don't go after my torso, they go after my feet. Remember, when bees get heightened defensiveness, they go after dark colors because a lot of their natural predators, bears, things like that, are dark in nature. So if you're wearing dark socks or dark shoes, you can anticipate potentially quite a few stings around the feet and ankle areas. So wear high-top shoes or boots that are light in color, wear white socks, and if you wear pants or bee suits, consider sealing those to the ankle area. Even if you do all of the stuff that I've described with you now, bees can still occasionally work their way into a glove, work their way up under a pants leg or into a suit, or work their way into your shoes. Bees sting, beekeepers get stung, but wearing gloves and protecting your ankles and feet can go a long way to limiting the number of stings that you'll get in these areas.